नमस्कार, वेलकम टू वन मोर एपिसोड ऑफ इंडस मैग्नेट। टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट वंदे भारत मिशन दैट हैज बीन स्टार्टेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सिविल एविएशन इंडिया। वंदे भारत मिशन इज बीन कंडक्टेड बाय एयर इंडिया एंड एयर इंडिया एक्सप्रेस टू हेल्प इंडियन नेशनल स्ट्रैंडेड अब्रॉड टू रिटर्न बैक टू इंडिया सेफली। बिफोर वी गेट इन टू द डिटेल्स ऑफ वंदे भारत मिशन, लेट अस ऑल्सो लुक एट द करंट कोविड 19 सिचुएशन इन इंडिया, ड्यू टू विच वंदे भारत मिशन इज नीडेड इन द फर्स्ट प्लेस। एज यू कैन सी, the number of COVID-19 cases has really spiked from a low of 1600 cases in April to around 23,000 new cases daily by July 3rd. This is a grim situation that will require a lot of effort from central, state governments as well as public at large to reduce the cases. To look at the overall numbers so far, India currently has around 670,000 COVID-19 cases, out of which a large number of cases have recovered, around 424,000 of them. Thankfully, the number of deaths is low at approximately 19,000 cases reported. Getting back to Vande Bharat mission, the background to this situation is the total banning of all international flights at the onset of COVID-19 by India from all countries. This has led to a situation wherein a lot of Indians with valid commercial airline tickets have no way of returning to India or even return back to other country as they are stuck in their current location. Due to this situation, a need was felt for Vande Bharat mission, which would be considered a rescue flight option to get Indians back from their stranded locations. Vande Bharat mission is being conducted in phases. Currently, it is in the fourth phase. Each phase consists of certain locations and multiple flights to airports in these locations. In the first phase, which was from 7th to 18th May, 64 flights were operated and 16,270 passengers were flown, both inbound and outbound combined. In the second phase, from 19th May to 13th June 2020, 325 flights with 75,297 passengers, both inbound and outbound, were carried. In the third phase, from 9th June to 30th June, 455 flights were operated and 1,32,000 passengers were flown, both inbound and outbound. In the fourth phase, from 1st July to 14th July, 80 flights are planned to be operated with an estimate of 19,078 passengers being flown, both inbound and outbound. A quick glance on countries where Air India flights flew in Phase 1 and Phase 2 indicate that India has tried to cover all countries as much as possible. Phase 1 saw more flights to region in India's neighborhood, and Phase 2 and subsequent phases saw Vande Bharat mission spread its wings across the globe to get stranded Indians back to India. Safety seems to have been of paramount importance for Vande Bharat mission. This chart shows all the steps that need to be taken prior and post-flight to reduce the risk of COVID infections. Similar to Vande Bharat, there was another mission called Samudra Setu, which led the rescue of stranded Indians using waterways. In this mission, two naval ships, INS Jalashwa and INS Magga, were used to rescue Indians from Male, Colombo and Bandar Abbas. The two naval vessels are fully equipped to carry large number of passengers quickly and safely. Let's briefly look at the two vessels. INS Jalashwa is an amphibious transport ship formerly called as USS Trenton. It is fully equipped to carry 1,000 passengers with all medical facilities. On the other hand, INS Magga is an amphibious transport ship which was built by GRSC Kolkata and is equipped to carry 500 troops or passengers with all medical facilities. In addition to rescuing passengers, Ministry of Civil Aviation also ensured transportation of essential cargo to remote regions of India, ensuring no shortage of supplies during the lockdown. It helped reduce disruptions caused by the lockdown, and around 588 flights have been operated by Air India, Alliance Air, Indian Air Force and private carriers carrying about 940 tons of cargo. Continuing the efforts of reducing disruption to essential supplies, a cargo air bridge was established with East Asian countries for transportation of pharma and medical equipment. Connectivity with key cities Shanghai, Guangzhou, Hong Kong and Seoul were established under this project. This is not all. Helicopter connectivity was also established to ensure remote and hilly regions continue to have uninterrupted service. Helicopter service provider Pawan Hans carried out operations in JNK, Ladakh and Northeast regions. A discussion on rescue missions would not be over without also mentioning the role of private carriers to this mission. Private carriers use their aircraft for conducting cargo operations across the country. Airlines such as SpiceJet, IndiGo, Vistara Airlines, Blue Dart carried out cargo support operations across India. With this, I hope this video helped understand the various rescue missions that are being carried out to ensure minimum disruptions due to COVID-19. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and also let us know your valuable feedback. Until next time, goodbye.